Spirit, breath of the living God, renew me and all the world.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Holy God, source of all goodness, you gave your Son for the life of the world and sent your Spirit that your love might abide within us. Teach us how to love each other this day, that we may have life and have it abundantly with you in Christ and through the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated as we turn to Scripture and Gabby.
A reading from Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 through 8. In this passage, Isaiah tells of his call to become God's prophet, which came in the form of a vision of God surrounded by angels. In this vision, after God cleanses Isaiah of his sin, Isaiah may speak for God. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on the throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had six wings, with two they covered their faces, and with two they covered their feet, and with two they flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the thresholds shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, I am lost. For I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? And I said, Here am I, send me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So this is an arrangement of Psalm 29, the psalm of the day that we'll sing for you.
A reading from Romans chapter 8, verses 12 through 17. Describing the new life of faith, Paul refers to all three persons of the Trinity. The Spirit leads us to recognize that we are the children of God, the Father, and joint heirs with Christ the Son. Join me in the reading. Brothers and sisters, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, it is that very Spirit hearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And as children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We turn now to our gospel. I invite you to rise as you are able for our gospel. We find ourselves in John again. Jesus has been performing miracles, and these miracles prompt Nicodemus to visit Jesus in secrecy under the cover of night. Jesus tells him about being born of the Spirit and about the Son who has been sent by God to save. Hear now the gospel according to John chapter 3, verses 1 to 17.
Glory to you.
Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God." Jesus answered him, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above." Nicodemus said to him, "How can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and the Spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I have said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly, I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I've told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him." The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated, and I invite our kids to come on up. My goodness, fast feet. You have a different vehicle with you today. Can you lift it up, Micah? Is it a truck?
No,
what is it? It's an airplane. Super cool. You drove the airplane? Did you get to go to a cockpit? Well, did you get to go into a cockpit, maybe? That would be fun. Maybe you will someday. Maybe you'll be a pilot someday. Yeah, that could be totally. Actually, I saw a commercial. They need pilots, actually. Yeah, that's, let me see a good look at it. Nice, United. Maybe you got that on the plane. I don't know. Pretty cool. Okay. I don't know if you heard me at the beginning of the service. Today is a special Sunday here. And it starts with a T. Here's a T. And it's the same name that we named our church. What's our church named? Yeah, Trinity. Yell that word. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, okay, let's try it again. 1, 2, 3.
Trinity.
Oh, I like that. Trinity. It's like in lights or something. Yeah, do you know what Trinity word means, that word?
Absolutely.
Yeah, no. It's a toughie. Trinity, so there's the word tri. That means three. Three. Whenever you heard the word like triangle, how many sides does a triangle have? Three. Yeah. How many wheels does a tricycle have? Three. That's right. Yeah. So whenever you see T-R-I, it's probably three. There's three. Okay. So what? Trinity, we talk about our God. So go like this for God. God. Whoa. Do it again. Ready? God. Good. Do it again. God. Yeah. So God is bigger than we can imagine. God is bigger than we can imagine. And we believe there's three persons, one God. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. So repeat after me. God the Father,
God the Father,
God the Son,
God the Son,
God the Holy Spirit. Yeah, it's kind of hard to wrap our heads around it. Three persons, one God. So it's really hard to use words to talk about it. Sometimes you have to go to shapes. Here. This, and every one of you has this shape on your bulletin, everybody. Look at your bulletin. Okay, so this shape can help us understand the Trinity. Now, I want you to put your finger at the top. So you see there's three sections of this, right? Put your finger at the top like this. Now you see three things, right? But if you follow it, does your finger ever stop? Keep going. Follow it. Follow it down like this. Good job, Micah. Follow it around.
It doesn't stop.
So even though there look to be three different things here, they're all the same shape. So this is one way we can try and wrap our head around three persons, one God.
It's Trinity, but more harder than you could imagine.
You're going to be a biblical, maybe a theologian. It's like infinity, but harder to imagine. That's the Trinity. Someone write that down, please. Yeah, it is really hard to imagine. So we can talk about it, but mostly it's how we feel God in our hearts, how we know that God gives us life. You're all sitting here. I'm sitting here, right? You're alive. That means God gave you life. And God, the Son, came to save us. And God, the Holy Spirit, makes us all brothers and sisters. So it's how we experience God. But another good way, you can take these back to your seats. Another good way to talk about or to try and understand, not really understand, but the Trinity is singing. So let's stand up. Ready? This is a simple one, and it's to a very well-known song. It goes like this. Can you put your papers down and stand up and look at me? It goes like this. God the Father, God the Father, God the Son, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, God the Holy Spirit, three in one. Okay, let's try it again. And so it's God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, three in one. All right, ready? Can we get some help from the congregation, please, too? This is a little harder. Okay, ready? Ready, guys? Here we go. God the Father, God the Father, God the Son, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, God the Holy Spirit, three in one. Once more. God the Father, God the Father, God the Son, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, God the Holy Spirit, three in one. Good job. You'll probably be singing that all day. Oh, hi. All right, come down here and we'll say our prayer. Come on, Ben. Can you take Micah's hand for me? Dear God, we praise you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, don't forget your sheets. You can call me. Grace and peace to you in the name of our Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, in our national life together, this is Memorial Day weekend. a holiday on Monday that we mark to remember those who have given their lives for our country. Some of you might go to Memorial Day parades. We have a really good one in Tarrytown on Monday. Because this holiday is scheduled every year for the last Monday in May, this holiday, this weekend, has become synonymous with the beginning of summer also. So with Memorial Day comes those parades and the promise of summer on the horizon. No school, hopefully a little bit easy of a work schedule. A more relaxed feel is in the air on Memorial Day weekend. There's a breeziness that, literally, with our fans, there's a breeziness that starts to happen on Memorial Day weekend. And then we come to church today and we find it's Trinity Sunday, the day of the church year when we focus, as we've been talking about, on our understanding, our Christian understanding of the triune God. There is nothing easy breezy about contemplating the Trinity, trying to wrap your head around three persons and one God will leave you going around in circles after a while. So as I was preparing today's sermon and service, I thought to myself, it's very ironic that Trinity Sunday falls on this weekend when this easy breezy vibe might make it really hard to take on this big doctrine of the church. But maybe I need to rethink that, think about this a little differently. Maybe this easy breezy vibe of the weekend can help put us in the actual proper stance for Trinity Sunday. Even that verbiage, as I wrote my sermon, that verbiage, taking on the doctrine of the Trinity, I think that needs a rework. We can take a different tack. Maybe we give in to the easy breeziness feel of the weekend, which can help us sit back and not fall into the trap of thinking that we can figure God out. The breezy feel can help us not be too self-important. The breezy feel can help us realize that it is not we. It is not we who figure out God. It's God who reveals God's self to us. And if we do that, if we sit back, if we give in, if we start looking and listening for God, what happens? We might start to look at scripture differently, these wonderful passages that the lectionary gives us today. We might actually sit and put ourselves in the shoes of Isaiah, the prophet, who in the year King Uzziah died, about 738 BC, for you people who like time, when he's given a vision of God. We sit back, that comes to Isaiah. We sit back with him and we see God on a throne, God who is so larger than everything, literally larger than life, that just the hem of God's robe fills the temple. And whatever tranquil idea you have of angels flying around in God's presence, you know, then popular art probably started in the, I don't know, Middle Ages or medieval time of chubby babies with wings. Lose those. That's not what's happening here. The seraphs here are winged cobras. They're winged snakes. That's what the seraphs are. And so you have these creatures, these majestic creatures around God, calling out to one another, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts." How is that for a scene that Isaiah gets let in on? In your mind's eye, it's terrifying and confounding. A scene that reminds that God is all powerful, larger than life itself, beyond what we can understand. And we're left in awe. It seems like a no-brainer to say that God is above all. God is larger than life. We kind of tune out when we say that. So you got to get lost in this vision that Isaiah shares with us. It's a message that we need to hear time and time again. God is above all. We humans are experts at making ourselves all, at making ourselves the center of attention. And so while we know and we hear the words that God should take center stage in our lives, but all of life, it's so often lost because the spotlight is saved for ourselves. Our culture itself is so focused on the self. We're saturated. If we were a sponge and like for everything in culture that is about the self, we would be, we'd be dripping with water, right? Dripping. I was watching television the other day and this, I came on right at the tail end of a commercial. I can't tell you what the commercial was selling, but it featured a little girl. She was on the screen, about 10 years old, and she was recounting her very busy schedule during the week. She came to Saturday and recited a litany of things she had, lessons and practices. And then she said, she came to Sunday and she says, and Sunday? Well, Sunday is me day. And I audibly went like this, oh, a 10-year-old, Sunday is me day. And it wasn't even that her birthday was me day. That's fine. Birthday should be me day, right? But Sunday, here it was, our Christian day when we mark Christ's resurrection, the Lord's day. The Lord's day being called a me day by a child. What are we teaching our children? She didn't call it family day. She didn't call it rest day. It was just straight up me day. Now, to be clear, I'm not knocking down doing things you like on Sunday. That's not what I'm saying. Go do what you like. Go barbecue, all those good things. And I'm not knocking down days where we need to take care of ourselves or birthdays like me days. But to call every Sunday a me day, that is something. It just hit me. Our culture is so focused with it's ourselves, do-it-yourself TV shows, self-help books, selfies we take of ourselves walking to the car. Who wants to see me walking to the car? I don't want to see me walking to the car. But it's everywhere. And again, taken by themselves, these things are okay in moderation and with right perspective. Pictures are fun, of course. It's good to unclog your own sink. Do it yourself. Yes, that's fine. Self-help. Yes, learn how to make decisions. But all of those things taken together give us the false notion that we are the source of all there is. That is false. And as Christians, we have to call it out. It's false, false, false. God is the source of all there is. God gave you life. God gave me life. God created all there is. And then God did something about the problem that we brought into the world, the problem of separation. That problem of separation caused by our sin and our own hubris. So God did something about it and sent God's son. God did something about it and sends the Spirit to give us one another and to share the good news with others. That's our proper stance today. Our proper stance is to see who is the center of all there is. If we just get over ourselves and look, we'll see the God who keeps coming for us, the God who just wouldn't take no for an answer, the God who will never take no for an answer in your life. When you say no because you want to handle it, when you say no because you're too busy, when you say no because you're too sad, whatever it is that makes you say no, I've got this, God, God will keep coming. The other day I was walking in the woods with my dog That's a big shocker. I know. I have a lot of walking with my dog stories for all of you. But I was walking in the woods with my dog. It was in the evening and it was before supper and I hadn't gotten supper started. So this was meant to be a really fast walk. So I was walking briskly and I was in my head about things that were going on in the week and very secondarily walking my dog. All of a sudden I start hearing this as I'm walking along. And I caught it. I mean, it was loud out of the corner of my ear. And I just was like, I just need to get this dog walked. So I didn't stop. Keep walking. Do you know, it just kept going. So my dog stopped. He insisted that we stopped and he stopped panting so he could get a better look and a better listen. I reluctantly stopped with him and it kept going. And I realized I actually really wanted to see what this was. It brought me out of my head and I started looking through the bushes because it wasn't up in the trees. And all of a sudden I see something hopping on a log far away, a rotted log. And I saw, we have birders here. I saw a red tuft on the top of the head, but it was really looked large. He kept going, and as I got a better look, it was the biggest woodpecker I've ever seen in my life. It was huge, and he was making a tulip tree. It was a downed tulip tree. It's been there for a long time. If you know anything about mature tulip trees, you know they're long. So he had a really long runway there to search for some dinner for himself. And I sat there with my dog. Oh my goodness, the bird looked like it was probably the size of a pheasant. I tried to get him on video. Can you believe it? Instead of being in the moment, I tried to get him on video and couldn't, and he kept going. I put my camera down and I just stood there and took in the beauty that I saw before me. And I stood there with my dog, kind of reprimanding myself for trying to get through a walk and the beauty of this kind of creation that God gives us. I had to stop. I had to open my eyes, open my ears, get out of my head. Trinity Sunday is a day to do that. Get out of your head, open your heart, look for some awe. It's a day to sit back and take our eyes off ourselves, to remember that God is God. We are God's creatures. A day to see where God is revealed in our own lives. Right now, where is God working in your life? Where do you need to pray for God to work in your life? That's what today is about. Because God is God. So sit back and take a look and take a listen. May the peace that passes all understanding guard our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus, our Savior and our Lord. Amen. Thank you.
God rolls away the stone. Come speak aloud of Trinity as wind and tongues of flame. Set people free at Pentecost. Go tell the world of wind and wolf that we are free to move. Within the dance of Trinity, before all worlds begin, we sing the praises of the three, the Father, Spirit, that voices rise and interweave, our love and hope set free. To shape that song is joy this life, the dance of Trinity.
Join me in professing our Christian faith in the words of the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Before we come to God in prayer, please share any additional prayer requests anyone might have this morning. What's his name? Claude. And he's ill? You said he's ill? Claude is sick? Very ill? Okay. Anyone else? Okay. Please respond to the petition of God of Mercy by saying, "Hear our prayer." We now come before the triune God to pray for our communities, ourselves, and our world. Abba, Father, you have brought us into your family, claiming us as beloved children. Bless your family of faith with gifts of cooperation and graciousness. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the world that through reconciling love of Christ, our destructive and violent ways may cease. Give your blessing of peace to the nations. On this Memorial Day weekend, we remember those who have lost their lives in war and conflict and give you thanks for their lives of service and sacrifice. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the mission of your church, that empowered by your Spirit, we may proclaim the good news of Christ to the world you so dearly love. God of mercy. Hear our prayer. We pray for all those who suffer in any kind of way. Bring them healing, give them comfort, and make them whole. We especially pray for Brian, Bob, Keisha, Jeff, Maurice, Judith, Joy, Eva, Craig, Bailey, Rena, Inga, Per, Alan, Myrtle, Gurpreet, Robin, Trista, Lawrence, Jonathan, Heidi, and Kirsten. We also lift up this morning Claude, who is very ill. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for your creation, that the Spirit move within us to care for the earth's well-being. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We remember those who have died and who have now come into their inheritance among the saints. As they live with hope in your gift of eternal life, so strengthen us in faith that we recognize your eternal presence in our mortal lives. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Receive our prayers, O God, and come quickly to our aid through the power of the Spirit, the love of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Today and always. Please share greetings of peace with one another.
That's peace.
And as always, this is the time in our worship for our offerings. If you've brought your gifts of possessions, please do place them in the offering plates in their normal spots. I invite you to pray with me. Merciful God, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. I invite you to rise as we move into communion. It is our duty and delight that we should everywhere Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit is worshipped and glorified, one God, holy and eternal. And so with the Church of all creation, the host of heaven, we praise your name and join your unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord of power and might. Happy is the earth, the full of your glory. Blessed is the one who comes in your name. All the things in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come, Christ's table is ready, and all are invited. You may be seated.
Thank you.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Let us pray. Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray. Amen. And now I invite you to rise so that I might bless you before we go out on this beautiful day outside, the sun shining through our windows. Receive this blessing. May the love of the Father enfold us, the wisdom of the Son enlighten us, and the fire of the Holy Spirit warm us. May the blessing of the triune God rest on us and abide with us now and forever. Amen. We sing our final hymn, Go My Children With My Blessing. Please stay on your feet for this final hymn.
You are the body of Christ.
Thanks be to God.